Hi everyone. Now we are here again for finite element method part 4. In earlier three parts, we were discussing about the basics of finite element problem, especially the basic steps involved in solving any class of problem. Then we had already discussed about the formulation of global simplicity matrices. Then in last lecture, we were discussing about applying the boundary condition, especially for structural problems. As while using the finite element method, we know that we are using this method to solve basically three class of problems: structural, thermal, and heat transfer. The very difficult part in heat transfer problem is applying the boundary conditions. So here today we will be discussing heat transfer problem for one dimensional case, how to apply the boundary conditions. Before going to that, firstly, we need to understand the types of boundary conditions. There are basically two types of boundary conditions. One is homogeneous and one is non-homogeneous. Homogeneous boundary condition means at a particular node, the value of displacement or your temperature is zero. In second case, the value of displacement or temperature is not zero. Basically, while applying the boundary condition for structural problem, structure problem means we were having simple beam is either simply supported cantilever or roller supported at a particular end. There, if any particular point is fixed, it means there is no neither rotation nor the displacement or vertical displacement. And on the right side, if there is roller, it means it is going to move left and right, but it is not going to move upward. It means there were restriction about say vertical direction. In the similar way, while solving the heat transfer problem, at a particular point, temperature would be given. If particular temperature is given, then how we are going to implement or input that particular temperature on this unknown field? Okay. So, to understand this, we have taken a simple problem. This problem is that insulated pipe is over there. Left side of pipe is maintained as 40 degree centigrade and the right side pipe is open with the atmosphere, and atmospheric temperature is about minus 10 degree centigrade. Now, the conductive heat transfer coefficient for this particular body is 35 watt per meter degree centigrade, and convective heat transfer coefficient is 55 watt per meter square degree centigrade. Now, to approach this particular problem, we need to follow those 9 steps. What was the very first step? Discretization. It means we need to divide this particular domain or domain of interest into small segments or small parts, so that we could know the contribution of local stiffness matrix of each individual part, then contribution of local force vector of each particular part, and then the field variable at each particular part. Here, when I am saying field variables means the quantity which we are going to find out. Especially in heat transfer problem, the temperature is field variable. In your structural problem, that displacement field, that U was the displacement field or field variable. So, to solve this particular problem, we have discretized this particular domain into 4 parts. There are two types of numbering. One is with circle, without circle. We have already discussed that to number the element, we need to circle that particular number. So here the particular element 1, element 2, element 3, and element 4 numbered with 1, 2, 3 with circle. Correspondingly, we have numbered the whole segment or whole element starting from left. Part 1 is having node 1, node 2. Then node 2 is shared between part 1 and part 2. So part 2 has the node number 2 and 3. Part 3 has common node number between part 2 and part 3. So it's 3 and 4. Then similarly, part 4 has common node number between 3 and 4. So it's 4 and 5. It means we are having 4 parts and 5 number of degree of freedom or 5 number of nodes. Now, to find out the stiffness matrices, especially K, U, sorry, it is column vector U and F. You see the difference. The stiffness matrix is for structural problem, but here we are naming that stiffness matrix into the conductance matrix, because in heat transfer conductance is everything over here. So we will also represent the conductance matrix using same variable, that K. Then in place of U, here we are representing it with capital T for say field variable. Then boundary your particular external conditions, force. Okay, so this is for structure and this is heat transfer. Done. Then especially we need to find out these three parameters: conductance matrix, then field variable, and then external conditions, which are given or specified for this particular class of problem. So we had already formulated the stiffness matrix, or in case of heat transfer it's called conductance matrix. This is your field variable, and this is external say your conditions. You need to specify the size of these. So what will be the size? Because we had taken 4 part and 5 nodes. So degree of freedom, how many degree of freedom? Degree of freedom would be number of nodes into degree of freedom per node. We had already discussed this particular formula on the previous lectures. So how many nodes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It means 5 number of nodes, and how many degree of freedom per node? 1. It means 5. So our size of stiffness matrix is going to be 5 cross 5. Then the field variable, because size is or degree of freedom is 5, it means the field variable would be column vector. It means 5 cross 1. Similarly, external condition 5 cross 1. We have used the formula derived for this solving the heat transfer problem, and we have already calculated this conductance matrix. In the similar way, the field variable at it particular node at T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, and correspondingly this. Now see, the right hand side or the external conditions, the column vector F having 3 subcomponent. FQ means external heat generation, it is due to the gradient, and this due to convection. So what I have written over here, it's F1 0 0 0 minus 1.08. It means I have taken the contribution of first, second, third. First, second, third means firstly you need to find out the F1, F2, F3, F4. It means for Q, then for gradient, and then for heat convection. Then you need to like assemble those particular variables, and then you will come to this particular values. This is our standard formula or standard practice to place the conductance matrix, field variable, and external condition in this equation. This equation is very familiar with you, because you have already used this particular equation for structural problem. Only difference is there, in place of T you were having the U. U means the displacement at particular node, but here it heat transfer, that means temperature. Now applying the boundary conditions, in comparison with the last questions or the structural issues, In structural issues, our objective was to find out the nodal displacement. Nodal displacement means, suppose there was a beam. Now, if I am applying F amount of force at any particular node, then how the corresponding nodal values are going to be changed. If I am applying external force, it means this particular beam is going to deform. Deform means either it is going to change its shape or it is going to be displaced in vertical direction. So at those particular nodal point, we were interested to find out the variable, it means especially the rotation terms, theta and the vertical displacement. In heat transfer, I have a single body, left face is maintained at a particular temperature. It may be the case that internally heat it generated or not. Then gradient is existing on left face, right face, or heat is flowing from right side, right side with convection. In these cases, we need to figure it out this particular matrix. Okay. Now the boundary conditions. In structural problem, boundary condition means the variable or field variable which is already known. If it were the fixed, it means the U value at particular node was 0. Here, the boundary condition means the temperature given at a particular nodal values. In this particular problem, we are already specified that the temperature at left face is maintained at 40 degree centigrade. 40 degree centigrade on left face means this is left face, this is right face. Left face is maintained at 40, it means at left face we have specified the nodal value 1. It means at node 1 the temperature or corresponding temperature is given at 40 degree centigrade. So in this particular field variable we are going to specify T1 is equal to 40 degree centigrade. Okay. The rest at T2 or internally they have not specified any temperature values. Kindly make a note that this minus 10 degree centigrade is the atmospheric temperature, not the temperature which is located or specified inside the boundary. So this is not our area of concern. Now, I have already discussed that there are two kinds of boundary condition, homogeneous and non-homogeneous. Our objective is basically to remove the corresponding rows and column where field variable is known. If field variable is known at the particular point, let's suppose in this case at node 1, T1 is 40 degree centigrade, then there is no need to find out the temperature as T1. If we are going to remove this T1 means corresponding rows and column, it means we need to seek the contribution as 40 degree centigrade at T1 to the other nodes, because in a structural problem is U is equal to 0 at particular point or V is equal to 0 at particular point. 0 means we were having the homogeneous boundary condition, but if that U or T is not is equal to 0, that means it comes under non-homogeneous boundary conditions. To implement the boundary condition, we need to seek the contribution of this 40 degree centigrade on the other element. After that, we can remove the corresponding rows and column. Okay. Now the question arises that if we are going to remove element or the contribution of T1 corresponding rows and column, so how to distribute the contribution on the other element? So basic fundamental clue is that if T1 is given, it means you are having the conductance matrix and this is your field variable. Every time you are going to multiply this particular first element with first, second element with second, third, fourth and fifth. Correspondingly for second row, first element, second element, third element, fourth element, fifth element, lastly first element, second element, third element, fourth element, fifth element. It means every time you need to share the contribution of T1 with the column number 1. This is simple clue. You need to figure it out. It means this is 40 degree centigrade and this is particular first column. first column means the contribution of this minus 40 degree centigrade is going to be affected only using these particular element of the conductance matrix. So how we will proceed for this type of boundary conditions? Only we need to multiply the corresponding node corresponding value to the given temperature and then transport this particular value on the right hand side. I'm repeating again, to know the sharing of this 40 degree centigrade, you need to share the contribution of 40 degree centigrade on other nodes, because this T1 is getting affected only through this element or this column. So we need to multiply this column with given temperature and then export that particular value on the right hand side of this particular format. KT is equal to F. So here first value, because minus 0.275 into 40 plus minus 0.75 into 20 plus 0 into T3 plus 0 into T4 plus 0 into T5 is equal to F1. It means the multiplication of 0.075 and 40 is already there. That is why for that particular row where temperature is existing, we are not going to multiply it. Then second row, minus 0.75 into 40, it would come around 11, then minus 11, because this is minus sign. So once you have 11, minus 11, you need to transport in the right hand side. So minus 11 is going to come at plus 11. Then third, 0 into minus 40, no effect, plus 0. Then 0 into 40, no effect. Then 0 into 40, no effect. Okay. Now, once you have taken the contribution of this given temperature at node 1, 40 on the other element, now you can strike out the first row and first column. Once we have strike out the first row and first column, now the matrix which is known to you for this particular problem is this. Would be size would be 4 cross 4, because one row and one column is removed, then your T and then your F. Size would be again 4 cross 1, 4 cross 1. Okay. The values would be 0.5 minus 0.275 00, then minus 0.275, 0.55, minus 0.275, then 0, then third 0, minus 0.275, 0.55, then minus 0.275, and last 0, 0, then minus 0.275 and 0.383. This is the conductance matrix and this is T2, T3, T4, T5. Then correspondingly, first value is 11, second 0, 0, and then minus 1.008. This is your standard format. Now, even you can check whether this matrix is correct or not. I have given the, or we had already discussed the property that this matrix will be always symmetric about the diagonal. So, if you draw the diagonal 0.55, 0.55, then this particular value, so you see that it is symmetric about the diagonal, upper triangle, lower triangle, they are their mirror image of each other. Now, this is reduced to 4 cross 4, 4 cross 1, 4 cross 1. It means you are having 4 unknown. Once you multiply this particular matrix with this column, equate this, you will land it up to 4 equation, 4 unknown. Now, because our objective is to find out these variable, so 4 equation, 4 unknown, you can solve those 4 equation, 4 unknown by various method discussed or say first earlier, either Gauss elimination or simple equation solving or any Cramer's rules. In summary, in heat transfer problem, to implement the boundary conditions, we have a separate approach. Separate approach because we were applying the non-homogeneous boundary conditions. In a structural problem, we apply homogeneous boundary condition. To solve a particular problem, we had discretized this element into 4 different parts. Then we have segregated or numbered those elements, find out the conductance matrix for element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then assemble those matrix, find out the field variable at every node, then find out the F vector, sharing of external heat generation, gradient and heat conductance. I'm really sorry, this is not external heat generation, but it should be internal heat generation. Then once you have found out K, F and K, T and F, put those values or arrange in this particular format. Here the conductance matrix, field variable and then F. Now to apply a particular value given at problem, especially this problem, left face 40 degree maintained, T1 is equal to known 40 degree. To remove this, we have taken the sharing of this particular T1 on the other element. Because of this T1, only this column vector is going to be affected. That is why we have figured out this column vector, then multiplied the each particular component of this column with 40 and then transported into the right hand side. Once we have transported, it means you have already shared the contribution of 40 degree centigrade on the other elements or other nodes. Now you can strike out. Once you have a strike out, your matrix size has been reduced from 5 cross 5 to 4 cross 4, 4 cross 4, 4 cross 1, 4 cross 1. 4 equation, 4 unknown, solved by any problem, and you will find out the variable, especially field variable T2, T3, T4, T5. And those are the parameter which you need to find out to solve the heat transfer problem. As per our plan, we have already discussed part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4. But I feel that there is one more topic, especially the numbering of plane truss. We will discuss that particular part later, maybe tomorrow. Thank you very much.